Annette!
You killed William. I'll never forgive you for that.
Wait!
I've just prepared a sample of the G-Virus. And this time, no one will take it from me. This is the most significant piece of research my husband has ever left in my hands.
Stop it! Sherry's in serious trouble. William implanted her with his embryos. There's no telling when they'll pupate. And if that happens, then Sherry won't... won't...
What? William... William... You're alive.
Oh, that was clever. Why is this woman so madly in love with a monster she knows is no longer a husband?
William is still alive. He's getting stronger with each skin he casts off. Sherry!
Tell me what I need to know. How can I save Sherry?
I have detailed information. Everything you need to know to prepare the antidote is right here.
Instructions for synthesis of the G-Virus antigen. G-Vaccine, codename Devil. Any beings infected by the G-Virus will reproduce through the impregnation of an embryo within another living being. Unless rejected by the host, the embryo will undertake a process of gradual cellular invasion, infecting the host cells on a module level as it rewrites the DNA. Once the metamorphosis is complete, the host will be capable of continuing this cycle of self-replication. The duration of time for the process to run its course will vary from subject to subject. In the early stages of its cellular invasion, it is possible to halt the progression of the metamorphosis through the administration of the G-Vaccine antigen. The following procedure details the synthesis. The vaccine creation requires the base vaccine. This can be arranged by the activator VAM. Firstly, set the empty cartridge into the VAM and activate it. After several moments, the process will be complete and the white colored base vaccine will be set in the cartridge automatically. Then confirm the green light is on. Remove the cartridge and proceed to the next step. Once the base vaccine has been prepared, set it in the vaccine synthesis machine located in the P4 lab experiment room. The machine is fully automated and only requires the user to push the sequence start switch. At this point, the program will run automatically and synthesis will be complete within approximately 10 seconds. As the synthesis of the Devil is an extremely delicate process, the quality will vary with the slight shocks or changes in the temperature. Careful handling is required for the proper results.
Save my daughter. And tell her I'm sorry I wasn't a better mother. Tell her I love her. Sherry.
Annette!
The self-destruct sequence has been activated. Repeat, the self-destruct sequence has been activated. This sequence may not be aborted. All employees proceed to the emergency car at the bottom platform.
Okay, Annette, I'm not telling Sherry any of that because you could have been a better mother when you had the chance. I've used the lab key. So I'm gonna go in this room and take care of another thing that is needed for the zapping mechanic to help Leon going forward. Where is it? Jam him off. Moth that wouldn't die. Okay, so I need to use this computer, but it's covered in crap. Shoot it. Will you operate the computer? Yes. So, go for all this, let it load up. Enter the name. We got a file earlier saying that if you're going to register, you need to register under the name guest. So that's what we're going to do. And register your fingerprint. Registration is valid for 24 hours. That helps it. Well, that's going to help Leon get into a certain part of the lab that Cleon. I'm melding the names together into one Resident Evil zombie killing hero. No. An area that Claire can't access, Leon can if we do what we're doing now in Leon's B scenario. For Leon to enter in the B scenario. So, now that I've registered the fingerprint, I have to go to the fingerprint reader for this door and do the unlocking part for Claire. Leon can then unlock it himself later. Am I carrying anything I don't need? Red herb, yeah. Ditch that at the minute. Excellent. Okay, so Leon's gonna go get the sherry. We need to make the vaccine. So we're going back. All the while, this place is getting ready to explode. Come here. Damn you, grey lickers. Side, so I need to go to the blue end. Jeez, over there. And with the key card, I should be able to get where I need to now. Doors at the end of here will currently be locked. There's a machine here, it requires two thumbprints or fingerprints. If Claire does this now, it goes yellow, meaning one fingerprint's important. When Leon comes to it later, that will still be important in the B scenario, meaning Leon needs to put his fingerprint in and he can enter that room. So we'll be showing that off. There you go, we all sort that out later. Now we'll enter this room. Card is useless, we can discard. Time to make a vaccine. Take the vaccine card. Turn on the light. See that there's plenty more zombies coming. Ah, damn it. Football! Oh, you got to have Modisk. Been waiting for that. Okay, so let's use that. Inserted that. Why is this thing not running? I know it is. I've done that. I want to get it to work. Okay, I swear I've done everything I need to do. I feel I must be missing something. There's only one place I can be missing something. Not that way. Gotta go a long way back. Okay. So the lab where I got the key card for, I believe I need to return there. Wait, Claire. Must be missing an item. And the only place it can be is there. So I shall return. Luckily, it isn't that far to go, but it's far enough. Dag nabbit! downs. Nice. And it. Oh, I better have this right this time. Ain't it, buying it. Okay, back into the default lab. Base vaccine must go inside. Well, what the hell? I was up in the room where to get the base vaccine. I put the cartridge in and it did nothing. Missing anything in this room. Okay, seriously, what the hell? I've ran all the way down here for nothing. I don't know why that machine's not activating up where I was, but it wasn't. Now I need to go back and make it activate. And it, burn it.